One of Monday.com's most standout features, in my humble opinion, is the ability to take your records or items and give them a meaning you get to define. That means a thing inside of Monday could represent a person, a task, an item, and you get to decide that directly inside the interface without being forced to just memorize things in your head. In fact, I love this feature so much that I ended up raving about it up in this video where I compared Monday to its top competitor, ClickUp.com. ClickUp.com. I don't know why I'm doing like .com as if they both do the, you know what I mean. I was comparing Monday with ClickUp up in this video, and I talked a lot about this because this is a key difference in the two tools. But you're here because you want to figure out what the heck is this, and I'm going to give you that answer. First up, let's talk about what exactly item terminology is, then why would you go about using it? We are inside Monday.com right now, and as you see, we have a bunch of different items in some default groupings. The item terminology piece is referring to this little guy right here. You see where it says add task and how each header says task in it? This is the term that Monday.com is using for the item, which is each row. Each row here represents a task because we have it set up to be so. If you're familiar with a spreadsheet, you can think of these items as rows in your spreadsheet, but with names you get to pick. Or if you're maybe used to Airtable, you might know these as records. Or if you're used to Todoist or ClickUp, you could think of these as tasks. But what makes Monday special is the ability to change this meaning to something else. The way we're going to go about doing that is to go up into our board settings on any board we have created, locating board settings, and going to change item terminology. This is the magic area that allows us to change this meaning. So if I go in here, I could change this to be dogs, for example, or dogu, because apparently I can't type. We're gonna go ahead and do dog. And now we see every time we go to create a new thing, it becomes a dog. By defining this meaning, it makes it easier for anyone who comes to this board to understand what exactly we are categorizing here. So if I have names like Ollie and Norman and Bella and so on, I'm just gonna start naming like people's dogs on the team. This is gonna have a lot different of a meaning than if I were to go up here, go to board settings, and have this item terminology mean clients. That's very different. And I want to make it very clear for anyone who's using my board to understand the meaning of the data. And by defining that data category or item type, we can be a lot more flexible in Monday than we can in competitors. Just keep in mind that these custom item types only apply to the overall item and not the sub items inside it. So if I collapse this, you'll see all of these are now clients. And if I expand them, we could have tasks or whatever else we want to have in between. These down here are always going to be called sub items. They cannot be reclassified. So that's how you go about setting up item terminology that's custom inside of Monday.com. Not only is it a standout feature that's pretty fun to mess with, doing these kinds of customizations is a great way to make sure your Monday is easy to understand by anyone who comes to your given board, and just allows you to add a little bit more of a personal touch to make sure things feel more fitting to your particular workflow. But that's an overview of what item terminology is. But just like every feature, I feel like when it comes to any software out there, it's a lot more interesting if you actually go in and play around yourself, because I can only show you so much in one quick video. So check out the description below. We actually have an affiliate link where you can sign up for Monday that helps support the channel, costs you nothing, and gets you that free trial so you can poke around yourself. And that would be the way I would go about exploring whether Monday feels like the right fit, or really what kind of item types would be the best fit for your workflow. Maybe it doesn't make a big difference. Maybe it makes a huge difference. The only way to know is to try it out. Now, the last thing I want to say before we pop off the channel today is a quick ask for you to go down below this video to the commenting area and write the word Monday if you are interested in more videos like this. If you haven't noticed, or if you haven't been around the channel, hello, my name's Layla, and we have not produced too many videos to date about Monday.com, but we are considering it, and I'm looking for you for feedback as to whether or not that would be helpful. So go ahead and write Monday and perhaps even your go-to video you'd like to see if you'd like to see more videos about Monday.com. All right, I appreciate your help, your feedback to help guide this channel, and thanks so much for watching. Until next time, enjoy the process.